guys, and welcome to the start of a new weekly reading vlog. Now, this week I want to read The Archive, which is just up to here in this Dark Vault bind-up, and I also want to get through Clockwork Prince this week. It's currently Tuesday. I want to have all of this done by Friday, which means I've got to read 200, 250 pages a day, and I'm pretty sure I can do it. I'm hoping I can do it, but I've also got a hell of a lot of other work to do, because I've also got to do some work for actual work that I actually get paid for. I've got to do my bullet journal, write at least one blog post, and I've also got to film and edit another video for Friday for the Slayer Fest readathon, because I've got to make my TBR for that, hence the Angry Angel Puppet t-shirt today, because if you're making a Buffy-themed video, you have to wear the Angry Angel Puppet t-shirt in my world, so I'm very excited for that. But I do also want to try and get through these books, so let's get going. Oh, and I also want to try and write something, because I got no writing done last week. Surprise, surprise. I didn't even manage to get any, like, blogs up at all. So that went well, because I did promise myself the week before that I was going to start writing again, and I just didn't. And quite frankly, NaNoWriMo is 5 weeks away. I need to get my ass in gear for Nano. So this week, I also want to start writing again. I'm going to start easy with a blog today, and then hopefully I'm going to kickstart the writing actually tomorrow. So let's see how I do. It's probably going to fail, but I'm going to at least try. Chapters in so far on page 50, and I'm quite enjoying myself. It's quite dark, but that's why I was expecting it's a dark book. I don't know why I was expecting anything different from V.E. Schwab here, so I'm quite enjoying it. But I've also just found out as well that my library has just got in my reservation of the first Death Note manga, which I'm really, really excited about, because I've had that on pre-order for a couple of weeks now. I've never really used our library before, but they've now gotten Death Note in for me, so I'm going to go over there on Saturday and get it, which is really, really exciting, which means I really, really need to get on with this, because otherwise I'm not going to finish all, how many pages? 329 of this, and all however many pages of this there is. Come on, how many pages? 496. So I need to get through 496 pages of this and 329 pages of this before Friday. Luckily, libraries let you keep books for like 2 weeks, because I think it's going to end up being an October read, quite frankly, because I don't think I'm going to get through these in the next 4 days. Unless I really go some. I should probably really go some, to be honest, but at the same time. Also, this morning, just finished filming my TBR for Slayer Fest, and I have already changed some of my books around for the prompts, because I was going to read Carry On by Rainbow Rowell for a couple of the prompts, but I have decided to change that now after finding out some more stuff about Rainbow Rowell as a person and as an author, so I don't really want to support her in that sense, so I'm gonna change it around, which is fun, because I'm now trying to find another book that has the hate to love trope in it, and I can't think of any, so this is fun. I don't know what to do there. Genuinely, I've no idea what I'm going to do there. So I'm just going to have to look through the rest of my books and my comics and pray, I think. Because I've already got the LGBTQIA plus character sorted, because I'm going to read Tone of Voice instead. And read another blue book, Knife by RJ Anderson for November, because I've already got my November TBR sorted. I think that's what I'm going to do. I've just got to do a bit of a swap round, essentially. So that's fun. So I've just gotten to page, 92, which is chapter 9. Still really enjoying this. But I have just realised that I'm probably going to have to stop reading this and go back upstairs again and re-film my Buffy Slayerfest TBR video, because I've suddenly realised that I did not put anywhere in the time we lost. And I'm going to be reading that as well during October, because it's a Carrie Hope Fletcher book and I always read those the minute they come out, and I haven't put it on my TBR yet. I don't know where I'm gonna put it on the TBR, Because I've just looked through and it doesn't fit any of the prompts, but I'm just sitting here like, oh, I buggered it up so bad. So I'm probably gonna have to refilm it, and I really don't want to refilm it. Just, oh, leave it off the list, quite frankly. I think I'm just gonna carry on as I did. It's just, my brain's not working today whatsoever. Like, I buggered it anyway. I'm trying to get my words out because I always suck at reading out prompts anyway, because reading out loud is something I find really, really difficult because I'm dyslexic. Then I completely got the prompts in the wrong order, and then I've now changed some of my TBR already now and stuff like this, and I'm just like, oh, just I'm having a day here when it comes to making videos. I am having a day. To the end of the day, and I have managed to read just over half of the archived at 174 pages, so it's not going too badly, especially considering I'm quite distracted today, and also this is not shaping up to be my favorite V.E. Schwab book. It's still very good. I'm still very much enjoying myself. The main male character wears eyeliner and black nail varnish, and that is something incredibly attractive to me, so I'm rather enjoying that aspect of it, and all the like the rest of the archive and the mystery to do with all of this. I do really enjoy that aspect of it. I'm just finding this a bit slower than I'm used to with V.E. Schwab books, I guess. I think the only way I can say when was this published, that will give me my answers there. 2012. So you can sort of tell that this is sort of more towards the beginning of V.E. Schwab's sort of writing career, I want to say. So that's how I'm going to put this. It's definitely more towards the start of her career than her, like, skill level now. It's still enjoyable, but it is not currently my favourite, which is fine because obviously not every V.E. Schwab is going to be my favourite. Otherwise, that'd just be ridiculous. Still, though, I am hoping to get that finished by tomorrow, so then I can go on to Clockwork Prince, which is also right beside me here. Hopefully, I'll get through that really, really quickly, like I usually do with Cassandra Clare books, but I don't know because obviously it is like 150 pages longer, 170 pages or longer than The Dark Vault is, and it's a bigger book that way, so I should probably say it's about 200 pages longer, I guess, to make up for that. But I seem to get through them quite quickly, so I'm hoping I can also get through that in 2 days. Otherwise, it's going to spill into the weekend and next Monday, which I don't really want it to do, but it will probably end up doing. But never mind, at least I'll have gotten it read, and then I can just go on to Clockwork Princess. But what I'm thinking, though, is that I may end up delayed anyway, because I have now decided that I'm going to refilm my TBR video, because quite frankly, it's a mess. And I forgot books, and I've changed books out from the TBR, quite frankly. So what I'm going to do is completely finalize the list and then refilm it tomorrow, which I really didn't want to do because tomorrow is my very tired day. But I'm going to do it anyway and hope for the best and try to remember all the books I have on my list this time, because otherwise I'm doing terribly here. So I want to refilm that tomorrow, which is a bit annoying, especially considering this is the only Buffyverse t-shirt I have, because it's the one with the Angry Angel puppet on it, which is my favourite episode of, like, Angel, favourite episode of the Buffyverse ever. And it's the only one I've got. I really like matching my clothes to the video I'm doing, but I may be able to find a vampire-y t-shirt or something that I'll be able to wear instead. But yeah, it sucks I've got to refilm it, but these things happen. So I'm just gonna refilm it tomorrow instead. And anyway, I had trains going past and all the rest of it yesterday anyway, so it's probably gonna be a good thing either way. So that's the plan, is to finish off the Dark Vault tomorrow, along with film a new video, and also get the Clockwork Prince done as much as physically possible, and also pick up Death Note Volume 1 on Saturday, because it's now in the library, and I'm not really going out until Saturday because we've kind of booked a hot stone massage on the high street in our village, because we deserve it after several years of unbelievable amounts of stress. So after we've done that, we'll go in, get the book, come home, relax, and then I may read it or I may leave it until next month. Well, now that I know I'm getting it, I should probably put that also in my TBR, so I'm gonna go do that now, I think. Yeah, I'm gonna go do that, and then I may also do this month's bullet journal spreads as well, because We are getting towards the end of September. I should probably sort out next month while I'm at it. Okay, so it's now Thursday because yesterday I spent in my mum's work canteen because, quite frankly, I wasn't waiting 40 minutes in the pouring rain for a bus. So my mum picked me up, but then she couldn't drop me off home again because obviously she needed to get to work. So instead I brought my books and I just sat in her canteen and basically just sat and read, which meant that I managed to finish The Dark Vault yesterday, or at least I managed to finish The Archived, which was really quite fun. It wasn't V.E. Schwab's best work, I keep on saying that, but it definitely wasn't her best work, but I still had a really, really good time reading it, and I really enjoyed sort of seeing bits of City of Ghosts sort of appearing in it, I guess. So I gave it 4 stars, it was quite good fun, but I also managed to read 55 pages of Clockwork Prince, which is quite frankly a miracle, because I thought I was going to take all day to finish The Archived, but I managed to finish it early. And after I did a bit of shopping, I managed to read 55 pages of this, which is fantastic. Now I've just got 2 days to try and read like 440 odd pages, which is 222 pages today and tomorrow, so hopefully I can get through it. But what I also managed to do over the last couple of days is refilm my video, which I literally just did, and I'm so glad I did because it's a lot smoother now, it's going to be a lot easier to edit, and I finally got all the books I want to read physically on there, which is great. And I also managed to do my bullet journal as well, which I'm really, really happy about because, quite frankly, it needed doing. I won't show you it though because, quite frankly, it is a mess of stickers and terrible, terrible, terrible handwriting, and you guys don't want to see that because, quite frankly, I just smother mine in stickers and, like, free printables from various places on Pinterest because that's just how I bullet journal, because I have absolutely no artistic ability whatsoever. I'm trying to think, did I do anything else? I don't think I did. I mean, I bought boring stuff yesterday, but actually what I keep on meaning to do is tell you about last week, because last week I was in town anyway because I had to pick up my new glasses because they're in the shape of the Hulk, and it also meant that I was sat in the canteen again reading comics. And because last week I was talking all about like Harry Potter, I didn't actually mention the comics I read, so what I thought I'd do is quickly update you on that now. Now, what I read was, if I can get the list back up again, because I've already forgotten, and I keep on forgetting at least one of them, so if I get the list up, at least I'll remember, because I managed to read 4 yesterday, which was, like, not yesterday, last Monday, which is a miracle. So what I managed to read was Descender Volume 1, which I reasonably enjoyed. I gave it, like, 3 stars, to be honest, because quite frankly, the art style wasn't really for me, and the story didn't really grab me, but I did find it quite interesting. I also managed to read Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3 Infinity Quest, which I really enjoyed. I gave that 4 stars, if I remember rightly. That's a really good, fun comic. I also managed to read Rat Queens Volume 3 as well, which again, I gave 4 stars to. Absolutely love that. I love the Rat Queens so much. I also managed to read Volume 3 of Legion, which was Revenants. Again, 4-star read. Thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it. And then also I managed to read Derek Landis' The Black Order, which, again, 4 stars, filled with Derek Landis' humour. Absolutely loved it. And all of that managed to help me get to 100 books in 2019. I've officially hit 100 books with The Archived, and I could not be happier. Naturally, 90% of these are, quite frankly, comics, because I seem to have had a really comic-based year, but at the same time, I'm so happy to have reached 100 books, especially considering my goal this year was 50, so very, very happy with that. I'm not going to try and read 50 more from now until December, because that's ridiculous, but I would like to get to about 125 if possible, which I think it's doable, quite frankly, with the amount of books I've got to read for the next 3 months, but we'll see. But also, before I go, I thought I'd show you my new glasses, because this is what they look like. They've literally got the Hulk on it. Literally, I bought Hulk glasses made for a literal child, because my head is small enough and I am that obsessed. Right, and this is what they look like on. I quite like them, quite frankly. I don't usually wear my glasses that often, because one, I'm lazy, and two, I just can't be bothered, and three, I don't need them that much. I just generally need them for long distance stuff, and I don't really do long distance stuff, but I take them with me usually to make myself look better, more intelligent when I'm at like a business meeting or something, and I wear them to every single new release of a Marvel film so I can see it in HD, even if that means I have to tackle glasses and 3D glasses at the same time. But I'm really, really happy with these. I may wear these more often than I did the last pair, I don't know. But I'm just really happy with the Hulk on the side of them. I would have gotten the Avengers ones, but obviously Steve's an old man, Tony's dead, and I reckon Thor's gonna die at the end of Thor Love and Thunder, so then Jane Foster can take over. So I wasn't risking it. So instead I thought I'd go safe with the Hulk, because I don't think they're going to kill him off, quite frankly. Even with She-Hulk coming, I think we're still going to see the Hulk for a long time. So I went with Hulk. Also, he's kind of my favourite male Avenger, so I had to go with Hulk. But enough with the waffling about glasses and comics and all the rest of it. Let's try and get 220 pages done of Clockwork Prince, because I think I can do that. I'm pretty sure I can do that. I calculated it if I went a page a minute at like 3.5 hours. So if I say 4 hours to be entirely sort of clear on this, I think I can do it. So let's get going. It's currently 20 past 11, so I've got a bit of time. Let's see if I can do it. I've just gotten to page 238, which is chapter 11 of this, and I'm still quite enjoying myself. Still have problems with Will Herondale, but I don't think I'm ever gonna not have a problem with a Herondale in one of these books. Herondales are sort of like how I feel about Slytherins constantly being evil, I guess. So I'm sort of having similar problems with these two books, but I'm still really, really enjoying myself. Even the romancy bits aren't annoying me, despite the fact that I am sitting here going, you've got Mortmain to worry about. Why are you worrying about which one you're in love with? But it's sort of more mild annoyance, more than I need to DNF this kind of thing. So that's not too bad. I'm enjoying the sort of what Mortmain's up to and what exactly Tessa is kind of thing. And I think I remember how this trilogy ends. I'm pretty sure I remember how this trilogy ends, because while I haven't read it before, my best friend had read this while we were still in school when we were in sixth form together, and I distinctly remember her telling me a play-by-play of what was happening in these books as she slowly devoured them. So I'm pretty sure she does end up, like, Tessa ends up with Will, and Jem ends up with the Silent Brothers? So I'm pretty sure I've heard Carstairs as a name with the Silent Brothers, if I remember rightly. And also, Will kind of has to end up with Tessa, so then they can end up making, like, further children, so they can end up with, obviously, Jace. So that's quite interesting. I'm pretty sure that's how this ends. Or I'm 90% sure that that's where the love triangle ends up, if I remember rightly, because I know one ends up a Silent Brother and the other one ends up marrying her, so I'm pretty sure that's the way it goes. I'll have to find out next month when I get to Clockwork Princess, but I'm 90% sure that's where this goes. Today's video here with this vlog, because to be honest, it's the final day of the Monsterathon and the Hogwarts House battles. I'm not really going to start a new vlog just to finish a book and then start a new readathon. You know, I'd rather just sort of carry this vlog on through today and then start a new one tomorrow on Tuesday for the start of a new month, start of a new readathon. So I'm just going to carry on with it. I spent my weekend basically having a hot stone massage, which was, well, very much needed after a year of stress, 3 years of stress. Who am I kidding? A year of stress. I've had basically 3 years of stress and a lot of it's just lifted. So we treated ourselves to a hot stone massage, which was unbelievably lovely. And then while I was out, I also managed to hop into the library and get, obviously, Death Note Volume 1. Because I really, really want to read this, and it's on my Slayer Fest 2019 TBR, so I'm gonna hopefully read this tomorrow, or at least this week. I'm quite excited for it. It is obviously back to front in every single way, because you've also got to read from right to left, so that's gonna be odd, but I'm gonna try it anyway. But that is for the next vlog, so I'm gonna shut up about it. And basically, the only other thing I did this weekend was watch Good Omens and Strictly Come Dancing. All I did. Basically, literally, all I did. So, I haven't finished Clockwork Prince. Otherwise, I would just be wrapping this vlog up now and instead spending my day reading fanfic because I've finished my entire TBR. But I've still got 169 pages to go, so I've only got today to read it, so I should probably get on with that. So, I'm going to get on with it. My only problem is that this seems to be a really, really slow read for me. I'm usually quite quick with these books, but it's taken me ages. But to be fair, I have been getting through a third of the book a day. So, I'm hoping I can get through this final third today. Otherwise, I'm screwed. Quite frankly, I'm absolutely screwed. So, I better get on with it. Because I've also got to try and finish this, edit this video, and upload it. And I have a feeling that this video is going to be up on Tuesday instead, again. Because I'm rubbish at uploading vlogs on a Monday. I should probably stop waffling, get on with this and actually, you know, read it so I can finish this vlog and then edit and upload it. So, let's get going. I just finished Clockwork Prince and I actually really quite enjoyed myself. I had a few issues with it generally along the lines of the love triangle because that's just not really my thing, and a couple of things I felt was slightly predictable, like Charlotte being pregnant and sort of Jem proposing and stuff like that felt a little bit to me obvious, but I still really, really enjoyed this book. I think I still prefer the Mortal Instruments as a series compared to the Infernal Devices, but I'm really, really looking forward to the final book, even though I know the first half of it just mostly focuses on the love story. I'm still really looking forward to finally finding out what Tessa is and how this all wraps up. And I think I'm going to give this 4 stars. And that's going to be the end of this reading vlog because basically I've now finished my entire TBR for the Monsterathon. So this week I managed to read the first book in the Dark Vault duology, which is The Archived. It wasn't as good as what I usually expect V.E. Schwab to be, but I do understand it's one of her older books, and I still do really quite enjoy myself, and I gave it 4 stars, and I also gave 4 stars, obviously, to The Clockwork Prince. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please do give me a thumbs up. Comment down below with what you read this week and what you thought of those two books. I'd love to know. I'll also leave a link down below to all my social media if you want to check out. And if you want to see any more of my videos, please click subscribe here. And over here will be the link to my previous video. But until next time, guys, bye!